Sierra needs 1.5 cups of ketchup to make her famous meatloaf recipe. She has a brand new 20-ounce bottle of ketchup in her cupboard. How much of this will she need for her meatloaf? To answer this question, we will convert 1.5 cups to ounces by multiplying by a unit fraction. So we begin with 1.5 cups, which we write as a fraction with a denominator of 1, multiply by a unit fraction that will convert cups to ounces. To form the unit fraction, we use the conversion 1 cup equals 8 ounces. Because you want cups to simplify out, and right now we have cups in the numerator, the unit of cups must be in the denominator, and therefore the units in the numerator will be ounces. Because the conversion is 1 cup equals 8 ounces, the unit fraction is 8 ounces divided by 1 cup. Notice by multiplying by this fraction, which is equal to 1, we don't change the value, we change the units. The units of cups simplifies out, or simplifies to 1, we're left with 1.5 times 8 ounces, which equals 12 ounces. So now we know Sarah needs 12 ounces of ketchup. Part B, write 26 inches in feet and inches. There are several ways to go about doing this, but let's be consistent and use a unit fraction. We'll convert 26 inches to feet and interpret the results. We begin with 26 inches as a fraction with a denominator of 1. We multiply by a unit fraction that will convert inches to feet. To form the unit fraction, we use a conversion 1 foot equals 12 inches. We want inches to simplify out, so we must have inches in the denominator and feet in the numerator. 1 foot equals 12 inches, and therefore the unit fraction is 1 foot divided by 12 inches. The inches simplify out or simplify to 1. Multiplying, we have 26 twelfths feet. Normally we would simplify, but this time we won't, because if we determine this quotient, we can determine how many feet are in 26 inches, and the remainder will tell us how many inches are left over. So let's find this quotient on the side. We have 26 divided by 12. Again, because 12 inches is equal to 1 foot, this quotient will tell us how many feet are in 26 inches, and the remainder will be how many inches are left over. Well, there are 2 12s in 26. 2 times 12 is 24. We subtract. The difference is 2, which means 26 inches is equal to 2 feet, 2 inches. Just to make sure this makes sense, 26 inches is equal to 12 inches plus 12 inches plus 2 inches. And 12 inches is equal to 1 foot, so we have 1 foot plus 1 foot plus 2 inches, which does give us 2 feet, 2 inches. And now for the last example, we're asked to write 5 pounds, 6 ounces in ounces. To do this, we'll first convert 5 pounds to ounces, and then add those ounces to 6 ounces to determine the total number of ounces. So we'll convert 5 pounds to ounces first. This will not be the final answer though. We still have to add 6 ounces. We multiply by a unit fraction to convert pounds to ounces. The conversion we need is 1 pound equals 16 ounces. We want pounds to simplify out, and therefore we have pounds in the denominator and ounces in the numerator. The conversion is 16 ounces equals 1 pound, and therefore the unit fraction is 16 ounces divided by 1 pound. The pounds simplify to 1, and we're left with 5 times 16 ounces, which equals 80 ounces. So now we know 5 pounds equals 80 ounces, so now we can write 5 pounds 6 ounces in ounces. 5 pounds plus 6 ounces, which is what we're given, is equal to 80 ounces plus 6 ounces, which equals 86 ounces. I hope you found this helpful.